Naja Modi, 28 years old, suffered a burn to her left hand as a result of a cooking accident.
Hey, what do we need to do here, Murphy?
A superficial, partial thickness burn should be managed conservatively.
Naja, are you having chest pain?
I think I'm having a heart attack.
Put her on oxygen at 1280 kg and order a portable chest x-ray. Murphy, let's move. Come on.
Her vitals are stable.
What the hell's going on here?
I don't know, but it is interesting. The EKG confirmed you weren't having a heart attack.
I wasn't faking. I wouldn't do that.
We know. Imaging also confirmed that you have considerable lung inflammation. Is it possible you inhaled smoke?
I guess I must have. There was a minor grease fire.
The grease fire?
Grease fire explains the whole thing, the burn, the smoke.
She told us she forgot the stove was hot. How can you forget something's hot when it is on fire?
Through the pharynx and over to grandmother's house we go. There's the epiglottis and the vocal cords. A lot of inflammation, but no smoke damage.
That makes sense.
I thought we were doing this because she inhaled smoke.
She said she inhaled smoke. I didn't believe her.
Whatever the cause, the inflammation and the damage are real.
This is a close biopsy. We'll move down here. Let's go reach your bronchial wall. She's hemorrhaging.
This is bad.
Prep the OR. Type and cross 2 units of blood. She's gotta move. Cut the suture. Let's approximate the edges with forceps.
Why did you lie? You said that you inhaled smoke, but there was no evidence of smoke. So what do you gain by lying to your doctors?
I wasn't lying. I was just confused, I guess.
Naja, what are you feeling?
I'm really sore. I feel like I'm gonna...
4 milligrams of ondansetron?
Airway inflammation, abdominal pain, nausea. We need a full blood panel and abdominal ultrasound.
Methanol is causing her abdominal pain.
She drank with alcohol.
People drink whatever they can drink.
Well, she's Muslim. Wouldn't let me touch her.
Religious people aren't immune to hypocrisy.
There are other ways to explain the presence of methanol. It's also produced by the liver when the body is exposed to certain caustic chemicals. Inhaled caustic chemicals could also inflame the lungs, and caustic chemicals also burn, so it would explain all her symptoms.
She refused initial treatment for methanol toxicity. It's ethanol. Because she's Muslim, she can't consume.
Your symptoms are consistent with exposure to dimethyl sulfate.
I've never heard of dimethyl.
Dimethyl sulfate is used to make chemical weapons. You're sweating. Perspiration is a sign of dishonesty.
My chest.
Chest pain can be brought on by anxiety. This time, you are having a heart attack.
Hey, it could be caused by an infection from the bacteria that has a result of puncture.
The treatments are diametrically opposed. Antibiotics if it's infection, steroids if it's inflammation. If we give her antibiotics and she needs steroids instead, it will suppress her immune system, causing the infection to flourish and kill her. If she needs steroids and we give her antibiotics...
I get it.
Her heart rate's 90.
That's in the normal range.
But it was 83. It should be going down. 5? You had steroids.
If we give her steroids, it will suppress her immune system, causing the infection to flourish.
I'm gonna push 40 milligrams of methylprednisolone.
And she'll die.
This is on me.
I know.
Switch that to methylprednisolone. It's working.
The fact that you're alive right now is evidence that you were working with dimethyl sulfate.
You're a terrorist, aren't you?
My brother works for a drug company. They use dimethyl sulfate to make one of their medications. He stole some from me.
So you could make a chemical weapon?
So I could make perfume. Smell that.
Beautiful, but very stupid.
Yeah, especially since my brother would get fired if anyone ever found out.
You believe her?
Protecting someone. Reason number 3.